Hi, I'm Stephanie Stevens. Very excited to be here with Kathy Griffin today. And I want to start out with a couple of questions about health and lifestyle, because I know she'll have some opinions on that. She looks amazing, as you can see.
I have a lot of opinions.
And that's why we love
you. That's why we're here.
Yes, absolutely. So, Kathy, what about your eating plan? I saw something about a salad with your name on it.
Well, I call it the Kathy Griffin salad. It's actually known as a Cobb salad. But yes, I have rituals like most comedians. So typically 3 hours before curtain, like if I have an 8 o'clock show, 5 o'clock, I will have a Cobb salad because it kind of has protein and the good stuff. And then after the show, I'm not so good all the time. But prior to performing, I don't want that feeling of feeling too full.
That makes sense. Now, obviously, whatever you're doing to work out is working for you. Share that with us, please.
Well, I work out every day, and I'm a big walking fanatic. I used to run, and then after a while, it was kind of taking its toll on my knees and doing so much stand-up. I mean, I'm doing 80 cities on my Like a Boss tour. Sometimes I'm doing two shows in one night, or a double, as we call it. And so, you know, I'm on my feet like a freaking cocktail waitress. And so I tend to walk and hike instead of running. But I'm a big proponent of whatever makes you feel good that doesn't cause injury. Like, I, you know, I've tried everything over the years, but believe it or not, like walking. And I also do crazy lady arm circles, which means, yeah, that's me. I'm that person that when you see, I'm going like this.
It works.
Yes.
Firms up.
And that way, you know, you can be out in the fresh air. You look crazy, but it works.
Hey, I also am very fond of talking about emotional mental balance. Mm-hmm. And you know, this is not a kind business. The world is sometimes not kind these
days. Stand up, it's brutal.
Oh, yeah, so how do you keep that together to balance those ups and downs?
Well, first of all, I really am a big believer in you have to laugh at everything. I mean, everything. So there are a lot of things that may sound inappropriate, but I've learned as a comic, everything should be on the table within context. So after performing in Iraq and Afghanistan and war zones, I learned you don't really hold back. And that environment might make you think, oh my gosh, I have to play it safe here. But it always depends on the audience. So everything should be on the table. But with stand-up, it's all about context. And I think what we're seeing now is a lot of people getting in trouble, saying things, well, if you're not a comic, it's kind of different. So I really do believe comics should, of course, have more creative license.
Oh. You know, you are a wonderful supporter of the LGBT community, an advocate. Give us your take on Caitlyn.
Well, first of all, it's Caitlyn's world and we're all living in it. So just accept it. My chips are all in. Hashtag Caitlyn. I do think it is funny because, like I said, you find comedy in everything. So I think it is hilarious that Caitlyn is the same name as this year's Bachelorette on The Bachelorette, and that she spells it the same way. And sometimes, you know, when I'm talking about one of the Caitlyns in my act, I might get them confused. So my real dream is that Caitlyn Jenner becomes the next Bachelorette, because I have big ideas.
Far out.
I'm always ahead of the game, and I think that Caitlyn Jenner should and will be the next Bachelorette. Because the Caitlyn that they had is fine, but Caitlyn Jenner is really bringing a lot to the table. Caitlyn Jenner's bringing the table.
One last question. What's coming up new for you? Anything you want to share with us?
Yes.
Any upcoming projects?
Absolutely. So I co-wrote my first sitcom script that I may or may not even be in because, you know, I am the new Mark Wahlberg. So,
well,
you know,
okay,
how he wrote Entourage, but wasn't it? So I just finished that, and that's really exciting. And the 80-city tour is great because I realize, as I look back on my whole touring career, I don't know what's wrong with me, but even I haven't done 80 cities in a year. I'm 54. I've clearly lost my mind, so come see me when I'm good and crazy, which is now. And I can't help it. I love it. I have a stand-up comedy disorder. I cannot stop doing it. And I, of course, would love to do another special, which would be 24, but luckily, the Kardashians are still around and giving me material. And I'm always looking for my next, like, steady TV gig. I've had My Life on the D-List, The Talk Show, Suddenly Susan, New Year's Eve, like, all kinds of things. But I still am a television animal, and I love it. So anything where I can be funny and make people laugh. And then in addition to that, on the road, getting in trouble anywhere from the grocery store to Carnegie Hall.
And don't get over your disorder, okay? Promise us.
My stand-up comedy disorder is a lifelong disorder. It's a condition that I live with and love.
Thank you so much, Kathy Griffin.
Thank you.
And thank you for joining me. I'm Stephanie Stevens.